get another power play with a little over a minute left. Bork comes back. Starts out from his own goal. Gets it ahead to Linsman. Less than a minute now. And the crowd feeling great about it all. It's just about over. Bork's shot kicked away by Fuhr. Puck outside the line. There's Linsman trying to find some room to poke it in. 37 seconds left. From the coaches to the goaltender and everyone in between. You're looking at a superb hockey machine to a man. They've done their job very, very well. Bruins in. Ladies and gentlemen, from coast to coast, the 1988 Stanley Cup champions, the Edmonton Oilers, have won it again.
His popularity, his skill, or his achievements. and he's still got a long time to play. And I'm for one. I hope he decides to play, but he's well into the 30s.
He's a great guy, a fabulous hockey player. He's just something else for this game of hockey. Wayne Gretzky, the Conn Smythe Trophy winner again. And now he'll receive the Stanley Cup. And listen to this crowd at the Northlands Coliseum.
The Edmonton Oilers.
Well, there's not a young hockey player in Canada, or North America for that matter, that wouldn't love to have his name on that cup. And Wayne Gretzky, for the fourth time in 5 years, hoists it over his head, much to the delight of his teammates and to the people who have supported the Edmonton Oilers all year long. They're passing the torch, and Bob, with the youth movement that St. has been able to engineer and make his team get better every year, this may become a habit.
And I'll bet you that Glenn Sather will make one or two changes before next season. And you might see this scene all over again. It's going to be a tough chore to dethrone the Edmonton Oilers.
Well, there are two newcomers, Cortland and Lacombe. What a privilege it is to lift that baby over your head.
The parade around the ice by the victorious Edmonton Oilers. Stanley Cup champions. 1988, there's Keith Acton now with Montreal and Minnesota. And he's here in Edmonton, and you think he's not happy? Here's another, Marty McSorley.
Marty McSorley turned into a defenseman just before the playoffs and did a wonderful job. And Smith, who probably was the best defenseman in this series, and Charlie Huddy's playing his first game since game three against Detroit. But there's the guy who's the chief engineer of this team.
There is the man, the great one, Wayne Gretzky.
That's Marty McSorley's father. He's shaking hands with down here at the end of the rink. We saw him last year. And there's a lot of the parents here. Greg Simpson's older brother, Dave, who graduated a few weeks ago from Western Ontario University and quite a hockey player in his own right, told me he wouldn't miss seeing his brother win the Stanley Cup.
And now the trainers get into it.
And the players who didn't play, Jeff Kukaboom, who played every game except this one, Charlie Huddy replacing him.
And the trainers just getting off the bench now. These are all the backup players for Edmonton. You see in the sweatsuits.
Jeff Kukaboom, I'm sure the players aren't thinking of it now, but later on in June when they get a fancy check for $25,000, they'll admit that the money isn't everything, but in the middle of June it helps.
Wayne Gretzky has taken the cup, and he's put it down at the Oilers emblem there, just outside that blue line. And the team, sweatsuit people and all, gather around the captain of the Oilers so that the TV people and the newspaper photographers can record this great moment for the Edmonton Oilers. You talk about togetherness and organization and discipline, and who's running the show? 99.
He's telling Sather, I've taken enough orders from you. You get out here and pose in this picture. You don't win this thing without good direction, ownership, management, and coaching. The Oilers got it all. There's the owner sitting behind the cup. Muckler and Sather will lay me together next year. Teddy Green, who I think's often the forgotten man on the coaching staff.
This is a first. Now they're calling for the trainers to come out. And here they come. I guess, Harry, it doesn't matter how many cups you win. They're all terrific. What an understatement. The Stanley Cup.
It's a marathon, really a marathon to win the cup. And don't forget, there are a lot of the key Oilers who started practice August the 1st this year and led Canada to the Team Canada Canada Cup championship in September. What a long season it's been for some of them. Sailor still has a few more people he wants in on this curtain call. And here comes Ted Green, who roared down from the press box to get in on this. Lauren Davis, the chief scout. Eddie Chadwick, Barry Fraser, Ace Bailey. They're all in that picture somewhere, and so they should be.
This is indeed a first. The Oilers organization has done a tremendous job with security here. Fans have been prevented from getting onto the ice, and only the media people are out there now with the 88 champions, the Edmonton Oilers. And a team picture has been done. An historic moment, no question. And the Oilers feel it's time now to take the cup one more time to the Edmonton dressing room, and the celebrations are on.
Barry Fraser, man responsible for drafting a lot of these players. Glenn Sather, among other things, is the best delegator of responsibility and authority to the people in his organization, and that's the reason he can coach and manage. So these guys have spent hours, miles, seeing 150 or more games. The scouts are right in the middle of it, so they should be. Here we are in the Oilers dressing room.
And Chris Cuthbert, we're happy to say, is along with our Hockey Night in Canada crew, and he'll be in there in the Oilers room in just a little while, and we'll get a chance to hear from the 88 champions, the Edmonton Oilers.
This is the fifth year the Stanley Cup stays in Canada, and this year there were more American teams fighting for it later in the playoffs than ever before. The Oilers are keeping it. There are a lot of people watching this telecast think it should stay.
And the fun breaks loose in the Edmonton room. The pressure released. Finally, it's over. We call this a four-game sweep and nearly five games.
Well, they won the games in a hurry. One of the reasons why the Oilers, I think, won the cup as easily as they did, and it wasn't easy, don't get me wrong, was that they got time between every round to recover if they were half hurt, to regenerate their enthusiasm. And we know the Boston Bruins came from seven games against New Jersey and five tough ones against Montreal and six against Buffalo. By the time they got to the finals, a lot of them were hurt and most of them were tired.
And so the final score in this final game, the Edmonton Oilers winning the Stanley Cup 6, the Boston Bruins 3. And our Stanley Cup coverage continues in a moment.